a UFO. It was a flying object, but
24-hour alien news coverage. I've got News Nation on YouTube TV.
From Mars, and I'm fine with that, but I still think that if they were more transparent in the moment about what things were and the lack of information.
All right. Get to the part I just haven't seen before.
Certain techniques have. I've been told that there have been attempts to bring down craft, that we've acted offensively against non-human craft.
There have been instances, and there are certain techniques.
Have human techniques. Beings been hurt or killed by a non-human intelligence?
Well, I can't get into the specifics because that would reveal a certain U.S. classified operation.
I think the techniques he's referring to for how they managed to down an alien spacecraft and pick it up is similar to this. I think what they do is you get the alien spacecraft owner on the telephone. You call them up and say, we'd like to, you know, make a treaty with you and trade alien spacecraft. And could you land it there so we can go get it? I'm pretty sure that's the technique he's talking about. Anyways, let's continue to do this.
I was briefed by a few individuals on the program that there were malevolent events like that.
What do you think?
Look, I mean, some of it's hard to stomach some of it. I mean, some of it seems a little out there, you know? Again, I go back to his credentials. The guy stacks up. It's interesting when he talks about things he can and can't talk about. He provided us with a letter, too. He actually got a letter from the Department of Defense. He went to them before doing this interview and told them what he was going to talk about. And there were things that they signed off on, and then there were things that they didn't want talked about. So, you know, he has a point when he says, look, I can't get into that. But, you know, it's...
See, but they can.
Yeah.
And I don't get the interest in the secrecy here. It's not like, well, Russia... sent this thing over here and we got it and we don't want them to know what we know about what it is. That's different. And they can tell things like that to you and me off the record as guidance for why their statement is what it is. That happens in reporting. This is not that. One last quick thing. Grush also claimed that we are not alone in the reverse engineering of these alien crafts. Listen.
We're in a competition with their adversaries to understand this. And it's a multi-decade Cold War that has been under our nose for so long. And, you know, there's no good way to level the playing field and hold other nation states accountable if they're doing unethical or illicit activity as it relates to the subject. And I think the obtuse secrecy is actually putting us in a very dangerous position where a country might make a breakthrough, let's say it's an adversary of ours, and it is so destabilizing.
The Pentagon put out that statement saying, we don't have any evidence of having re-engineered anything.
This is why I question, I mean, he's talking about Russia and China. He later said that in the interview, that Russia and China also have these pieces of craft. I mean, is it really possible in today's world, social media, camera phones, everything, the way we communicate, that this could all be a secret in multiple countries? I mean, I guess if they're spending an enormous amount of money and there's only a certain amount of people that know, but, you know, I understand why people are skeptical.
Oh, yeah, look, they love getting each other's stuff so they can break it down and figure it out.